This is an error in reporting, which is really quite concerning because it's causing some headlines that are inaccurate. I think we need to be perfectly clear that WHO has not abandoned studying the origins of COVID-19. We have not, and we will not. I spent more than an hour speaking with this reporter over three separate interviews, one of which was in person while we were in Singapore together, describing the history of the different missions that have taken place over time in which WHO has been involved in studying and supporting field activities related to understanding the origins of this pandemic. Initially, phase two was a plan to be a continuation of that January 2021 mission to Wuhan, which was in a sense seen as phase one. But we updated our plans, and I've explained this to that reporter. I mean, in a sense, phase two became SAGO. So we were building on what was done during phase one and establishing the SAGO as a permanent strategic advisory group to conduct an independent assessment of the origins of COVID-19, but also to work more broadly to establish a framework to understand the origins of any future epidemic and pandemic pathogen and the origins in which it emerges. So the creation of SAGO was, in effect, our best effort to move this work forward. We made this very clear in several statements of SAGO, several statements by the Director General, by myself, by Mike Ryan, in different press briefings, but also in statements that we published online. SAGO is an incredible group of experts from around the world that have come together and have met multiple times, including two times face-to-face over the last year to advance our understandings of this. I think I also want to make very clear that in this article, there was a suggestion of a quiet shelving of a plan. There was no quiet shelving of any plans. We have been and we continue to be open, transparent. We brief our member states regularly in the wider world on where we are with finding these origins. But let me also be very clear that we continue to ask for more cooperation and collaboration with our colleagues in China to advance studies that need to take place in China. Studies were recommended from the March 2021 WHO report, from the June 2022 SAGO report, and studies that we've been recommending, studies at the animal-human interface and markets on farms. These studies need to be conducted in China, and we need cooperation from our colleagues there to advance our understandings. We will follow the science. We will continue to ask for countries to depoliticize this work, but we need cooperation from our colleagues in China to advance this. I do also want to mention that through the work of studying the origins, it's very difficult. We had always envisioned multiple missions to China for particular technical aspects, but also elsewhere, wherever the science takes us. And we have worked with additional member states around the world to understand and follow any lead in terms of any early indication of SARS-CoV-2 circulation. And we will continue to do so. We just need to make sure that it's very clear that we haven't abandoned any plans. We haven't stopped any work. We will not stop until we understand the origins of this. And it is becoming increasingly difficult because the more time that passes, the more difficult it becomes to really understand what happened in those early stages of the pandemic. So the DG may want to add to this, but we will work with any member state and all member states. We will work with scientists to keep it rooted in the science until we have a better understanding of what happened, follow all hypotheses, follow any science that leads us in any direction. And we thank the colleagues around the world who are helping us to advance this. Thanks.
Thank you much, Ruta von Kerkhove, and we have the Director General to add.
Yeah, thank you. I think following up on the origins study and knowing how this pandemic started is very, very important and very crucial. And we should continue pursuing. As you know, the two reasons why we need to know the origins of this pandemic. First, it's science. And second, it's a moral issue. First, when I say science, we need to know how this started in order to prevent the next one. Second, when I say moral, millions of people lost their lives and many suffered, and the whole world was taken hostage by a virus. And it's morally very important to know how we lost our loved ones. So it has a science and moral issue. And we need to continue to push until we get the answer. As Maria said, we're continuing to push. And recently, as recent as 7 weeks ago, I sent a letter to a top official asking for a top official in China, asking for cooperation, because we need cooperation and transparency and the information we ask in order to know how this started. So I assure you that we will continue to push, we'll continue to pursue until we get the answer, because this is scientifically correct and morally correct to really pursue and understand the answer to the origins and how this pandemic has started.